cause it's a brand new selection for your musical ear.
Only investment of music, not even wonderful capital of FM. Hello, Martin.
good afternoon, Charles.
Good afternoon, Martin.
And good afternoon, DJ Leo.
DJ Simba Vipi Kakavana.
Good afternoon to everybody out there. In fact, when I say good afternoon, if you're not driving, stand up and answer and say, good afternoon, Mwalimu Martin. How are you? Good afternoon, Solo.
Good afternoon, Soki. Good afternoon.
Koja kidogo, washa my mic.
God damn it.
Washa my mic, brother. Here today,
we want
to present you as small show.
I am
an investigative show.
Today we're investigating everything.
But before we start, we want to tell you guys that there's an amazing plan starting next week, Thursday, to Sunday. I don't know who's a golf. I don't know who here is a golf fan.
Maybe so.
Me, I'm learning how to play.
You're
golf.
Learning how to play golf. Why?
Why?
Why are you learning how to play golf?
My age doesn't allow me to play any other contact sports anymore. So I've moved on to something that's a bit more of my caliber.
So you don't want to play golf because it's fun. People dress up. The events are always nice. You get to network with serious guys.
It's the next best sport for gentlemen. We played rugby.
Uh-huh.
That was where the gentlemen started.
Uh-huh.
Now we're taking it onto the greens.
Uh-huh.
Where now we dress for the occasion.
Uh-huh.
You have to have the right shoes,
yes.
The right trousers or shorts,
uh-huh.
Polo shirt,
uh-huh.
Or, you know. And then over and above that, I get to network.
Uh-huh.
I'm eating.
Because the question that begs the question, man, to actually solve about the conversation that happens between the two.
What
have you said?
What have you just said?
Because you're networking. Between the two holes, there's a conversation that happens. Between the two holes, there's a conversation.
There's a certain bank that has been, you know, supporting pros over the years,
mm-hmm.
and supporting the Magical Kenya Open over the years. For 11 years they've been there.
Mm-hmm.
That's ABSA.
Yes.
They have a plan for everyone
from
next Thursday to Sunday. I'll let you know what that plan is in this hour.
So
you go on.
In short, what I think you tell us is block off the weekend. There's a plan unlike any other.
Okay. But for now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, so look at you.
From the investigative corner
to the news desk,
weighing around 150 pounds.
150 pounds.
Two hundred and ten.
150 pounds is
small. Stop mentioning my name.
Sour. Let's do this. Born and raised in the slopes of Mount Kenya. From an area not many know, but is known for its tea.
Uh-huh.
A beautiful place by the name of Tigoni.
Tigoni.
We bring you John Allan Namu.
Quick question. We just start off the quiz. Quick question.
Then
we go into we pay some bills. Who are you?
Martin.
Wait, what are your answers? It's that what you mean. I didn't ask you, asked John Allan Namu.
But that's such a deep question.
Yeah, that is why.
Philosophical.
Yeah, come up with that. Yeah.
Let me do the quick one. I am a father of four children.
Yeah.
Four?
Hey! Four.
Wait. No. Congratulations.
Four.
Mm-hmm.
Four.
Boys and girls or boys?
Three boys, one girl.
My friend.
I'm telling you.
Solo has three girls.
Yeah. So I have.
Boss, in this economy. Anyway,
but it would be me who would be paying you mahari. So
by the way,
mm-hmm. can start now doing stuff in advance.
Uh-huh.
I am. I am a journalist.
Yeah.
An investigative journalist at that. Sijui nijiite media owner.
That's true. You and Marianne Kirubi were same, was that?
By the way, I was just having like, anyway.
Yeah.
I'm just generally a person who tries to be a good person. And
what?
And I also am a member of a rugby club that beat Impala last week.
With that, we're going to go into a short commercial break, and we shall be back talking to John Allan Namu. I'm Anza na Matusi.
Violence.
Follow DJ Leo on at DJ Leo Saha on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
We've been smoking herbs. give me some chopper. Load it like big gun, I load with copper. Load it up proper, hear me now, me dapper. Rasta go earth with no cracker, earth with no lacquer. If I the one thing, me say no bother. Some like the high grade herb with the grubber. I like it natural, so does my brother. Warrior, action, no bagger, lover, lover. We are no brother, boss, and we are no criminal.
I'm a ganja head.
No matter where you take it, analog or digital,
I'm still a ganja head.
Herbs are my sacrament, very, very spiritual.
I'm a ganja head.
And the high grade herbs me sexually.
I'm a ganja head.
Then if no one in the dead, just a draw will do. Smoke it up now, no matter make it mildew.
Saha on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
I'm just tempted to touch, you know. Yo, B, just make sure you know where I'm going.
Would you be offended if I told you I like the way you lick your lips? Would you be offended if I showed you how I like to work those hips? Is it rude for me to wink and let you know I like what I see? Would you be offended if I touched you? Imagine how
you're like a jewel, baby. This ain't no pickup line. It pity me of a lady, truly one of a kind. Rare and precious diamond with unpolished shine. Can't fit to hold you close, girl. Can you read my mind? Clear images for which I won't apologize. I hope that you can see the passion in my eyes. Won't overstep my boundaries. These words are hard to find. State of my intentions. Hope you're my way inclined.
Tell me if I'm wrong. Expressing how I feel. How can I go on?
Baby, my Valentine. Can I hit the make you wet temperature there? If you leave me a good time, I swear. You are like the oxygen I need to survive. I'll be honest. Loving the thought of me, I am so obsessed. I want to chop your own heart. I need it back and it's real. But now make us real.
It's 27 minutes past 3 right here on your best bits of music on 8.4 Capital FM. How are you doing? Absolutely lovely afternoon. Thank you so much, DJ. Ngoja kidogo DJ Leo mwenyewe. Fantastic music.
In the building, of course, got John Alanamu, yes. Solom, Munywa, Martin Karaoke, Charles Kiarie,
yes.
Leo Saha.
He's
walked anyway. Out in protest.
Okay, quick question, Solo, for
yes.
John.
Yeah. Yes. So, first things first. I know lots of Kenyans have always wondered. Are you able to walk the streets of Nairobi?
By the way, by without, yourself?
Yeah. Okay. Without having to look over your shoulder?
Or do you need like a team, like Nondis behind you?
Good luck. I see where we're going. Yeah. It's okay. I shall return with a response.
Yeah.
Okay. You know, Nairobi, I think everybody needs to look over their shoulder when they're walking in. It's
true.
Not just me.
Yeah.
Like, there are some corners over here, usipoangalia vizuri, we, you know. But generally speaking, no. I mean, the serious answer to this is that I try and do everything as factually as possible. That's what we try and do. And that's our biggest protection. That we are not there to kona, you know, we have some sort of axe to grind against you or whoever. Mm. Whenever you do a story, it's really about the public interest.
Mm-hmm.
And what that does is that it's helped us gain credibility with the public, and they become our defenders.
Okay.
Yeah. So for the most part. Lakini, of course, you know, there are those ones where it goes overboard.
Are you into golf, by the way, by any chance?
You know, my dad tried to make me play golf. Like, I have an interesting story about why I don't play.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to learn, but it's kind of frustrating.
So next week, Thursday,
to Sunday, actually, the Magical Kenya Open, presented and brought to you by ABSA, of course, is going to be happening at the Muthaiga Golf Club.
Mm-hmm.
So basically what we want is for guys to, you know, send us a photo of themselves. You know, golfers and people attending golf are always looking good. They're always dressed up well.
Yeah,
so man. As you're going to learn golf, John, we want to teach John Alanamu how to dress up when he shows up at that event. You understand?
Okay.
Yeah, so that he can be interesting as well to look at. You know? So what we want you guys, listen, this is a simple question. We want you guys to send in a photo of the look you want to have from Thursday. What am I saying?
Actually,
yeah.
Let's do this. Yeah. We're helping John Alanamu
fit in
when he goes for golf. Magical Kenya Open.
Yeah.
Tell us what you think would be the ideal outfit for him.
Yeah.
For the 3 days.
For the 3 days.
Yes.
You use the hashtag KO Sleek.
Oh,
the hashtag is KO. MKO Sleek. Oh, MKO Sleek. Oh, yeah. Okay. MKO Sleek. And of course, the other hashtag is The Boys Live. We're trying to help John Alanamu here. Please, let's go in there at the Jam 984. Let's help him dress up for the Magical Kenya Open presented by ABSA.
Let's remember that he does not shop from Baby Gap like Charles.
So
man, you have to mention my new heart of Vipi Bang.
Charles is a game of bubble gummers. So, yes.
All right, we have 3:30 right now.
In Capital Newsbeat this hour.
Four parties signed cooperation pacts with Jubilee ahead of NDC. Uhuru will never betray me, Raila assures ODM delegates. And Ukraine urges residents to protect the capital.
More in Capital Newsbeat. Follow DJ Leo or at DJ Leo Saha on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
You are like the oxygen I need to survive. I'll be honest. Loving the thought of me, I am so obsessed. I want to chop your heart. Never did it back at this feel. But now make us feel. I'm a love wanting to make a bad man.
When we get to the
enter party, all the girls them go shake their body, go shake their body. Oluwa bona mo bona belly, dem mo bona belly. You know the money you take up police, me I dey love you, Connie. Grace and no number, but I just pray you the money on your mind. You supposed to know, send me no be newcomer. So my baby make you no go dollar, no go dollar. When the bed with the enter body, all the girl them go shake their body, they go shake their body. Oh, do I wanna go on off it?
Take sight till you're loving the light. Life ain't all that unless you're doing it right.
Come on.
Keep on.
bird. It's a plane. No, it's DJ Leo coming to save the day.
Ain't no pressure. It's the rap son of man. You gotta understand. I will survive. But this time, it's for Shantae Savage. And we gonna sprinkle it with a little bit of common sense. And we gonna bag it a little different. You know? I'm gonna let my man Sir Hurley get on the boards of production. Ain't no more discussion. Yeah, yeah. Ha, ha, 1, 2, this is what I do, hey. So long as the beat goes on, so long as the beat goes on. Ha. So long as the beat goes on, so long as the beat goes on. Now work it out.
So long.
As the beat goes on, so long as the beat goes on. So long as the beat goes on.
1, 2, 1, 2, this is what I do.
I was afraid, I was petrified, thinking I could never live without you by my side. And I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong, but I grew strong. Should have made you leave your key. If I'd have known for just 1 second, you'd be back to bother me.
Today I'm the one selling DJ. Hey, Solo. Okay, man. Okay, that's how we start the show.
Whoa,
22 minutes to 4 o'clock.
See, no, some of us only know the chorus, so that's where we start. That's where we start the song from.
My goodness.
Oh,
that was the that you deserve to be in a karaoke host. Just sing badly.
As long as I'm out with Farid and Davina.
Okay. But this is the boys live, guys. Karibuni sana. If you have any questions for John Allan Namu, please ask at the Jam 94. The hashtag is the boys live with a Z, of course.
Yeah.
But we're talking about the ABSA, Magical Kenya Open, presented to you by ABSA Bank itself, ABSA Kenya. Now, we need you to go and buy a ticket early and come enjoy the magical moments of golf at the Muthaiga Golf Club. That's next week, Thursday to Sunday. Tickets are available on tikiti.com. Thursday is only 1,000 shillings. And guess how much it is from Friday to Sunday? 2,000 bob.
Ooh, as a seasonal ticket.
For 3 days.
Seasonal ticket.
Seasonal ticket, yeah. You remember the ones for the Safari 7?
Yeah. Yes.
The same. Like this one now. This this is the thing. This is the main thing. For those of you who are looking for the biggest event happening apart from the elections, this is the one.
Actually, away from the election. I think we need a break from... There's more to life than just elections.
A bit of fun. We need to also show that sport is huge and show that sport can be partnered with and can be done proper.
Absolutely.
This is the Magical Kenya Open. It's part of the European tour.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Guys, this is huge. And it's next week, Thursday to Sunday.
Mato, just do this. Let's break it down for us, guys. So there's a goal that's happening.
Yes.
And then there's a place us guys can chill and watch the goal.
Exactly.
So if I'm not that person who can who has the energy to go around all 18 holes.
There's an area, a small village for you to go and chill,
mm-hmm.
enjoy the vibes. Sit down, enjoy your
and still
drink,
follow
your
the
lunch,
proceedings
your
from
food. Is so much happening.
And the beauty about it is we've got local celebrities. I'll call them celebrities because they represent us at this particular event.
These
they
are
will be there.
Our four pros, and these are the ones sponsored by Absa. Basically, this includes Simon Ngige,
yes.
David Waku,
yeah.
Mohit Medirata,
yeah.
and Daniel Duva. Now they've been sponsored for a total amount of 2.7 million shillings. This will include 300,000 shillings that will go towards provision of all items they need during the tournament. Their shirt, gloves, golf balls, among other items, and a 2.4 million cash sponsorship that will be split between the four. Okay.
I think it's a beautiful thing because if we do not support our own at a certain prestigious event, then who else will?
So basically what we want you guys to do is help John Alan Namu when he shows up to that event on Thursday to Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
How should he be dressed? Kwanza on Thursday, the first day, you know you have to come and show guys, well, I'm
a serious Kenyan.
I'm a serious.
No, there's a difference how guys dress for rugby
yeah.
and there's a difference how guys dress for golf.
Yeah, that's true.
So,
so how do guys for golf dress?
That is what we're asking guys to
help us.
to help
us. The light leading the blind.
Yes.
We're also looking for the same information.
That's what we're using you. We're using you to investigate.
Okay.
To investigate
Amirani.
How you will do it. So, John, quickly, how did you get into this line of work that you're in?
Investigative reporting.
Did it start in high school?
Primary school.
Did it start in primary school? Did you feel? Can we start from there?
Was that niche in primary school?
So,
or was it
actually
a need to provide information that people do not have?
so actually, my bro would agree with you. It'd be like umseni mdakwa.
Yeah, no,
but it started much later than high school.
Yeah.
So I mean, there were inklings here and there that you know. That I'd be interested in journalism. So when I got into my first into uni, my first degree was IR, international relations.
Nice.
And after a semester, I was like, this is not me. Then the journalism program had now just started picking up.
Mm-hmm.
So I checked in there and it just worked. Then now when we got into work, after about a year of scoping everything out, I'm like, no, the news docket stories aren't interesting for
mm-hmm.
me. So I got into features. Alafu tukapatana na Moha. And then now we got into investigative reporting together.
What was the first story you guys did together? Or the biggest?
Okay. The first was some con men over here in town.
Mm-hmm.
guys who are stealing.
Wait, tell me why you're looking like that.
Yeah, so it was about some con men in Tao over here, guys who are stealing stuff from people.
Yeah.
Then there was the one we did on the car tracking company. Now, that was the one that really launched us as a duo of investigative reporters. So there was a car tracking company that wasn't installing the car tracking systems. We found it. We went. We questioned them, and the guy offered us a bribe.
Oh, you know?
Yeah. It was $10,000.
Yeah.
Oh.
And this is 2009.
Ooh.
Matro is pulling out a calculator. Wow. Okay.
So this 2009, and it was 10,000 with a promise of 5,000 more if we don't run the story. So akatupatia zote tukaenda tukampelekea my boss. My boss, I don't think he's ever been so shocked in his life.
Yeah.
Because we brought it to him in the evening, and the guy was like, hey, what do I do with this money? He took it straight downstairs to the CEO.
Oh.
The CEO at the time was a Katol Kaleo guy called Paul Melly.
Oh.
The guy was like, this boys need to be protected a lot. And then now we got, you know. So before we knew it,
we were protected.
We were protected by the government. Yeah. And so, before the story ran, I got news from a couple of friends of mine, and then Moha got from a couple of friends of his that this guy is upset. He's found out that we're running the story because we've done the promo, and he's looking for us kutuumiza. Mm. When Meli heard that, he was like, vijana, just take them out of the country. So we lay low somewhere in this country for about 2-3 days. Tukikunywa tu soda, tukingoja. Well, I have to say soda because this is the afternoon. Water shall not fika. And then that was the first and only time actually that we got bodyguards. So when I say that this guy was saying we must be protected, the guy was then joking around.
It was a real story.
Yeah, like the night before we left the country.
Yeah.
Moa had this very, it's almost like they picked personalities and of the bodyguards, right? So Moa had this very like lean, like really cut
kagai,
yani
kauka
amekauka mbaya.
Yeah.
Me, I got this bulky tall guy, you know, those guys where you see yani uyu sasa ukicheza na yeye, just the face.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can you remember the bouncer from now, this is for what were NSSF, the bouncer from
Aizo.
Crooked Q's,
Aizo.
Yes.
Aizo.
He was a replica of Aizo.
Wow.
So that night,
okay. Let's take a short break. Got a couple of messages, some bills, and then when we come back we'll pick it up from Aizo.
Yes.
Okay, let's do this. General Lamu, thank you so much for gracing. DJ Ngonya Kidogo, to our Rudan Moyo Sasa.
Get ready to experience a master at work. Y-O-U. DJ Leo.
Hey.
L-O-V-E.
Y-O-U. Hey.
Here's a box of chocolate, a dozen of roses.
Yeah.
L-O-V-E. Where's the fire extinguisher? Because it's smoking in here. DJ Leo.
Here's a box of chocolate, a dozen of roses.
Ever since you came back around the way,
I ain't trying to be a player.
So many things that I wanna say.
Like what?
Oh, I got a little wiser. I don't wanna lose your love tonight.
Taller.
I don't wanna lose your love tonight.
Hey. I ain't got many friends I can talk to.
Nowhere to run when I'm in trouble. We don't have to keep it undercover. I don't wanna lose your love tonight.
Toddler.
I don't wanna lose your love tonight.
Toddler.
Come on.
L-O-V-E-Y-O-U. I ain't tryna lose your love tonight. I just wanna make you feel alright.
Toddler.
L-O-V-E-Y-O-U. I'm just hoping you can spend the night. Kiss you, love you, hold you tight.
Since you came back around the way,
I ain't trying to be a player.
So many things that I wanna say.
You know I got a little wiser. I don't wanna lose your love tonight.
Toddler.
I don't wanna lose your love tonight.
Toddler.
Ain't no need to leave, girl, please close the door. And don't forget what I told you.
I wanna do you right cause I did you wrong.
Another show that they cry up on. I don't wanna lose your love tonight.
Toddler.
I don't wanna lose your love tonight.
Toddler.
Come on.
L-O-V-E-Y-O-U. I ain't tryna lose your love tonight. I just wanna make you feel alright.
Toddler.
L-O-V-E-Y-O-U. I'm just hoping you can spend the night.
A lot. Several mornings she shampoos my locks. Always have my back, she stand true to that. Real type of loving, thank you for that. Yo, run barefoot without the shoes and socks. Cause she keep herself clean and I got cash, no rush. And she love me for real, I'm not for you have no cash. And any little thing and from a splish, you splash. Yo, all this blinging is like you forgot. Use cheddar reservate the new recruit a rat. So we listen, couple speech of Martin Luther chat. Then it's Brown, Bob Marley, and some super cats. Yo, it seem like she live upside the Duke of shop. Cause she don't have a scratch, it's only beauty spot. When one duty start is when one duty stop. 1 9 to 5, 1 5 to 12 o'clock. You see me?
Beautiful,
the master at work, DJ Leo.
After the show is the after party, then after the party is the hotel lobby, then after the Velvet, then it's probably Chris, and after the original is probably this. Yes, my Betsa, Fiesta, remix with the homie from the Midwest side. Game recognized, game do too. It's a new two live crew, I suppose you're new, so clubs. Toasters, but don't approach us or to chase you like Moet Mimosas. Catch us both coasters, racing twin poachers, boxers with to the pop you to make you closer. Whoever come closest, you've been warned, but don't get the picture till the is drawn. Make your way backstage, baby girl is on, and we'll be drinking till 6 in the morning.
In the back of the club with my mom, popping bottles of Chris with my mom. Put the bar on the tap for my mom, throwing hundreds up for grabs for my mom. Cause it's about to go down tonight. I'ma be drinking till the early is high. Shout it like I'm kids. I take 300 just to make me feel as I. My, 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 my. It's what they all say when they see the frozen eyes. They say, my, 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 my. Anytime they see them big things on the side. Why y'all got a club that I'm fucking with arenas? Got your man saying, have you ever seen her? Yeah, she with me on the low, getting off the kind of on the floor. Fiesta.
Fiesta.
Kama mishuma, especially mimi na manga, na mimi, wana niita habibi. Wana sema mi uspit pile lakini mi uspit hivi. Bila mimi haiweze kani, bila switch kimota akisha aje. Bila nare blaze itabamba aje, bila tembo kweli utapewa aje. You better stop relaxing, question asking. Get on the floor and don't stop dancing. Get on the floor and don't stop dancing. Get on the floor, Pianta je.
I need to comment on this one quickly.
Yeah,
the vodka drinkers, there might be a problem. Russia is at war. And there are sanctions, so vodka might be reduced.
So guys are fighting, but you're seeing the worst thing that can come out of this is the price of vodka will go up.
Yeah, man.
Very much so.
Or the supply will stop.
The supply. Can you imagine the cocktails that we have to buy? How much will they cost? So low, if you're trying to get a mama.
But are the cocktails that you're buying made out of vodka or something from light
you
industry?
Guys, okay.
Mato, you just need to step up, kiddo.
No, yeah. Step up to what?
To
finer
drinks.
Money.
Finer drinks in life.
See, you guys pay me better. Anyway, guys, listen. We are going for the Magical Kenya Open next week, presented to you by ABSA.
Mm-hmm.
We have tickets to give away, and the tickets include drinks and food. And it's a simple question. We want you to help us all, including John Alan Namu, on how we're supposed to dress up when we show up at the Magical Kenya Open, presented by ABSA next week at Mothega Golf Club, Thursday to Sunday.
Yeah.
So that's all we want to know.
The thing is, we're helping out John Alan Namu. At the same time, we're trying to help Chalo. Chalo comes to the office with counter suits. This is what, now the difference, at when he's trying to be less corporate, it's short-sleeved. And then when he's feeling corporate-ish, it's long-sleeved.
Formal and informal.
Yes, formal and informal. He don't even have a shirt inside. And then the only shirt he has a collar bigger than the jacket itself.
So you're saying he kunjas it on
the jacket. The shirt on the jacket.
How did you guys know I had a counter suit back in the day?
Not back in the day, Charles. It's your only suit.
You seriously have a counter suit?
I had a counter suit.
You wore a counter suit?
I wore a counter suit back in the day.
Moving on swiftly, please let us know.
With plastic shoes.
I
Sandak.
Yeah, Sandak.
No, thank I you, know Alan. Because I can read. relate. Hata sisi kama watoto au kuvalishwa kaunda suit.
You ask guys didn't have money.
We walk tenge that my dad refused to wear. So my mom, my bro, my sis, all of us, we couldn't even get lost. Ule amevango kama yangu.
Material. That thing was material. She was like cattle and a long material in Gikomba.
And then Kenyatta Market had all these mafundis who used to say they used to pretend they're from West Africa.
Yeah.
But atengenezea wewe material. Material let me atengeneza.
And his name is
then he's like, hey,
Joroge. Joroge. Odongo.
We know.
But anyway, this is what we want you guys to do. Please let us know how we should dress up. You know, when we show up at the Magical Kenya Open, presented by Absa next week, basically the tickets are 1,000 shillings, Friday to Sunday, 2,000 bob. You can get your tickets at tikiti.com. Get your tickets right now.
Mm-hmm.
So, at the Jam 94, the hashtag is MKO Sleek and the Boys Live. Let us know right now. The tickets include drinks and food.
Wow,
so get on there right now. We posted the question on At the Jam 94. Now, quickly, back to Izo.
Uh-huh.
We were talking about the way you are under threat
yes.
from a certain individual who offered you guys $15,000.
Dollars.
Which is now about 15 million cash money.
No, that is now, it's 1.75 million shillings.
Now, it's about 17.5 million shillings.
No, that's 150,000.
What do you mean?
Yes.
150,000. In 2009, listen, in 2009,
yes.
it was $15,000.
$15,000.
What was the exchange rate in 2009?
2009, it was
around 85.
So it was slightly lower than.
And then you don't see that it's appreciated and all those things and money. But that's 12
future,
years.
Future value of
13 years.
Oh, actually,
13
but,
years.
But
bro.
not by that much.
You're sure?
Yeah.
Not 10 times.
Hey, 10 times ningumu.
Aya, 4 times.
Yeah, sawa.
Ekoyo, my guy.
Yeah, I see you've done the mathematics.
Ekoyo,
they're wishing you have been given the money. So yes, so you're given the money. You're given your bodyguards.
Yeah. So we're given our bodyguards and so Moha, him, I don't know where he went. So we were told we split up for that evening before the flight, the following night. So me, I went home. And that time I was roommates with my bro and my best friend.
Uh-huh.
And so my best friend was like, see, we go, we catch pints at Queens. I'm like, you know, I'm not supposed to be out.
Yeah.
So it's like, okay, so it's a random like Thursday evening. So we went and we check in, we sit at the bar, and this was before Queens did that whole extension and stuff. We sit at the bar, and then, you know, everyone's drinking, and then now guys notice, who is this guy? And you know, they're looking around, has anybody employed someone to, just hulk around at the door?
Oh.
And so my friend now just remembers that time from how, even when we went back home, Mse Ali lala kwa sitting room. He's just there chilling for me because our flight was pretty early the following day. He's just chilling for me. So if I'm cut like this, I'm hearing a guy is already. It was crazy. Like, I don't understand how guys with bodyguards can live. This
okay.
too intrusive.
Yeah. Okay, we're coming into back into that.
This is not neat. Hamaki, this is real life.
The real deal.
All right,
let's get to the news right now, of course. And of course, we'll be picking up from there because now we're seeing people getting chills. Martin, for the first time, getting chills. A rugby boy getting chills.
Yeah. What? Come on.
Hey, it's always a party with DJ Leo on the ones and twos.
Yeah, check it out one time for the ass.
It's a bird. It's a plane. No, it's DJ Leo coming to save the day.
Here's a tune about this honey named Renee that I met one day on my way back from John Jay. I'm peeping shorty as she's walking to the train. I tap her on the shoulders. Excuse me, miss, but can I get your name? She said, my name is Renee. I said, I got a whole lot to say. So may I walk you to your subway? She said, if you want. So yo, we started talking. I brought 2 francs and 2 drinks and we began walking. I had to see where that head was at, cause the year was mad fast. So we must chat about this and that. She told me what she was in school for. She wants to be a lawyer. In other words, shorty studies law. I'm telling shorty, I'm a writer, and as she's looking for the token, she drops her back into the easy water. Covers her mouth with the name ring. I say, yo, I don't sweat the technique, shorty rocks. I do the same thing, but yet I use Philly blunts. She said, I never dealt with Philly blunts because I heard that's for silly stunts. I said, nah, they burn slower. Right now, I really don't know you, but maybe later on I can get to show you. A ghetto love is the law that we live by. Day by day, I wonder why my shorty had to die. I reminisce over my ghetto princess every day, give it up for my shorty. A ghetto love is the law that we live by.
know I jam, I know I jam, jam. Bobori, I know I jam, I know I jam, jam. Well, all damn, why don't you jamboree for me? Kaboom, yes, kaboom, indeed. The platoon came on in, made limbs and tims. Broke brims, smoked stems, who dogs with bent rims. For the real and the raw, no, who duck from the law. I never kill for the thrill, but I cut for the call. Smoking with a hooter, get better prices from looters. Shake my shell with the shooters, meet a Luger with Duja. Some say modeling and acting, maybe Tretch is selling. While I'm yelling for some felon with my the melon. Booyah, hella heated, too ill for them to beat it. Most cheated, most needed, you best believe it. This ticker tape's jam for me, stand for me. You damn to be without the jamboree. I come out, I know I jam, I know I jam, jam. Well, oh damn, I know I jam, I know I jam, jam. Oh boy, I know I jam, I know I jam, jam. Well, oh damn, why don't you jamboree for me? Yes, indeed.
We put it down since the days of high school. And everywhere we mark, we rule. No, these about to raise our stock. And we didn't come to brag about what we got. We came to rock. We blew the spot, taking the streets to pop. You beefed our style for a vibe and co-wrote our chop. Using the last few years as my evidence. Trying to duplicate the mixture ever since. You're living fine, you're reprimanded. Challenge me, guaranteed. When we finish, I'll be the last man standing. Terror noise forever in demand with K-drop tracks, all the party people jam.
I wanna see y'all who wanna play with me. Wave your hands, cross the land if we family. Say hi, damn, hi, damn, we want a jamboree. It's for my peeps here, I stand for you cause you stand for me.
Oh, come on, I know I jam, I know I jam, jam. Well, oh damn, I know I jam, I know I jam, jam. Oh boy, I know I jam, I know I jam, jam. Well, oh damn, why don't you jamboree for me? Yes, indeed.
I ask the thugs who have mercy in these days is dirty. I'm still sturdy and flirty to my dirty for Jersey. The funk is pat booted, lights, camera, shoot it. I just did it to do it, do it, do it, do it, do it, do it.
Your head's nodding, your feet are stomping. It's gotta be DJ Leo.
I'll always think of you inside of my private thoughts. Can't imagine you touching my private heart. And just the thought of you can't help but touch myself. That's why I want you so bad. This one night I want you right there with you there beside.
man known as DJ Leo on the Boys Live Solo, Mato, Chalo, and Jono.
Hello.
And that guy was singing that song.
That's, who's that guy?
The guy.
The guy. Oh, guy.
Guy.
Did you know?
Guy. Guyo. Guyo, will tell me what you want. Oh. Right now, I'm going to tell you something about something Solo cannot pronounce. Samsung.
Oh.
Imagine being able to live at night the same way you live during the day. A world where there are no rules. Samsung Galaxy S22 has given you the ability to do it. You can literally take photos during the night the same way you do during the day. The nightography is amazing. Camera with sharper shake, longer battery, brighter display, built-in S Pen, and stronger durability. Change it up in the morning to find out more with Davina and Farid.
I'd suggest you pack your bags and let's get ready to go to Brazil with Koi Kabbalah this particular weekend because she has hooked up with the Brazilian embassy and they'd like to take you for a tour of Brazil. Now, if you tune into the World Group show, you can get to visit the...
Hey! I was waiting for that.
The amazing Iguaza Falls. Uh-huh. Walk through the Copacabana and soak in the sun on the serene beaches of Pernambuco.
Nice.
For those who have been to the Sweet Carnival, well, this is your chance. And for more details, all you need to do is tune into World Groove from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. tomorrow, Saturday, right here in your best mix of music.
And we'll be sipping a sweet Tusker Malt Lager right now as we listen to John Alan Namu's scary story. First of all, you were at Queens.
Yes.
With a big guy.
Yes.
Hovering around the
hovering.
That's when you say Hulk.
And he wasn't a rugby player, so he was much bigger than your prop forwards of today.
So guys were wondering when they got a new prop forward.
Yeah. No, first they wanted to sign him maybe. Yeah. I don't know, but yes.
Nameva, black suit, like it was proper movie stuff.
Wow.
So when we go home, I've packed my stuff. At 3 a.m. nimeamka now to start going to catch the flight. You know, when you forget, like in your sleep, then you find a guy in your house.
Wow.
Then the guy is much bigger than you, so you're like, guy, sasa tumekujia. We can't do anything. Then I remember the guy.
Mm-hmm.
So we go to the airport. These guys are like Moha's guy, alikuwa na mbwembwe sana. Like he was hanging out of the side of the door. Like when we got to the airport, he came out. He must have been those guys of presidential escort. Yeah, like he did the thing that, you know, the way they jump and run out of the car.
Yeah.
Like he did it seamlessly. Then we get to the airport and we're off. So then we go, we land in Zurich, and Moha had brought a camera for us to document the entire experience. Mimi ni nani mshamba? Now I'm looking around this very clean airport. I forgot the bag, right?
Ooh.
Yeah, I forgot the bag with the camera.
Oh,
Mohamed Shikanari. Now, because like I remembered when we sat down in the plane and we've taken off, now we're going to Germany. But and I really must credit these guys. Like a month later, we came back ilikuwa untouched, kila kitu, yani with a camera inside. So I was just wondering now, kama ingekuwa Wilson, now what would have happened?
Either Mogadishu or it would have ended up in Kitale, various places.
There'd have been someone with it. Yeah. So that was the first like big story.
Can I go off tangent kidogo? Now seeing that the weekend is coming, that $15,000.
You know, times have changed. That if I had it now,
yeah,
that one Tungetesa mbaya. Like if it was back then and I had it, Tungetesa. Lakini sahi ni mahitaji, alipa school fees ama ni rent ama utafanya nini. Kuna bibi hapo atasema ati hapo ni gawie.
Oh yes,
there are problems. I haven't been taken out for nini. Why are you like this? You're such a Kenyan man.
I do know she's listening right now.
No, naenda kichapo, but I know. Doghouse is a revolving door. Unaingia ukitoka.
So there's a guy called Hagai Alan who has actually done the calculations for us. $15,000 in 2009 is now $18,600 in 2022. A lot attempt to give you the Kenya shilling, but it's about 2.1 million shillings. Hiyo 2.1 million shillings ukikuwa nayo sahi tu imeekwa tu hapo hapa. So that you can quit your job, Charles Kiare, from that seat right now. Would you?
No.
You wouldn't.
But can I tell you something?
Mm-hmm.
And this one I have it on good authority.
Yes.
Not 2.1 million.
Yeah.
There are journalists right now today wanakula hizo pesa na zaidi.
Wow.
Because of
to kill stories or to write
kill,
stories.
Kill, write, massage, all sorts of things.
So we should not always believe what we read.
No.
Anyway, remember, if you want factual news, That's the best place to go. www.capitalfm.co.ke. We do not receive $15,000. We do not receive $18,000. We receive nothing, but what we do is give you the truth of things just the way they are. Absolutely. And you can get more details on this right now.
Time to let DJ Leo does what he does best. Total satisfaction, guaranteed.
Oh yeah, here we go. Your sex is got it going on. Oh yeah, your sex is got it going on. Here we go. Your sex is got it going on. Don't you know? Your sex is got it going on. I told you so.
I want your body, tell me your woman too. There's a many nasty things I wanna do to you. Lick you up and down and around, that I love of mine could never ever be found. Now you see me, and baby, now you know. Pacify me, girl. Just give me what I want.
Give me what I want.
Make it real good to my very last drop. Nom 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 nom, honey. Don't you ever ever stop. Go. Oh, come on, sugar. You know I love you so. Make you feel like you never did before. Oh, here's the key, baby. Now open up the door. Now you see me, baby, now you don't. Oh, come on, honey. Just give me what I want.
I need it.
I love you, but say I feel so good inside. Baby, try to run, but you just can't hide.
anyway, cause I love it.
Friday. Time to let DJ Leo does what he does best. Total satisfaction guaranteed.
You
The group, it is a TLC. Yeah, that's fantastic. 27 minutes to 5 o'clock right here on your best mix of music, 9.4 Capital FM. It's a lovely afternoon right here, jamming with the boys.
Of course, we are jamming with the boys. When you're telling you guys, especially the guys who are waking up in Panama City right now, Frida and Alvo, if you're woken up with any aches and pains, guys, we have something for you. It's known as Cipladon. Cipladon painkillers are here. Cipladon is absorbed twice as fast, giving you faster relief so you can get back on track. Tune in to Capital in the Morning with Davina and Freddie to learn more. If your symptoms persist, seek medical advice. Once again, shout out to Alvo and Frida. They've said hi to Jonah Lanamu. Yeah, Alvo said he's lucky he didn't play against him in rugby. Ange Maliza. And also shout out to someone who actually works for More Radio in Mombasa.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Listening to Capital FM.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
But it's More Radio, not More Radio, is it?
Yeah.
So you know who owns More Radio? You don't know.
Ujui.
How do we? Partner work in crime.
Yeah.
Shout out to Miss Madai.
Super.
Miss Madai, well, listening done to us, the boys live, by the way. And also shout out to everyone else who's listening, all the Woodley guys, Kwanzaa, what were Woodley, Ametoka, Sujui, Lower Woodley, all the way to Jose Shop Pale, and then upsides, downsides, all the guys out there. Shout out to you guys. Now back to Jicho Pevu. I want to know, first of all,
yes,
who came up with the name?
Jicho Pevu?
Yeah.
Well, so Moha.
Moha.
Yeah. So it was Jicho Pevu and the inside story. Yeah. So Moha did Jicho Pevu, I did the inside story, but essentially it was the same thing. Yeah. But yeah, Moha is the one now who would come up. So Jicho Pevu was like the title of the series. Then now he'd come up with Jaramandia la uhalifu, Parwanja la mihadarati.
Why did he have to use such hard words?
Zengwe, bandarini.
We couldn't tell somebody, did you watch Nini? Because we can't say it again.
No, but you know, for me, zengwe.
Yeah, for me it was helpful because nilikuwa najifunza Kiswahili.
Nice.
Me, I was like, I've never heard Parwanja before. So when he came up with the name, I was like, "Sahi Parwanja." And for like a month after that, we used to call each other Parwanja.
So how did you guys basically start off? Like, go look for a story. Did people call you with leakage, or did you guys just go out and investigate for yourselves? Did you come up in the morning? You're like, I hear there's another story down here.
Let's go find out.
Yeah.
So it's both, actually. So a lot of the things that we've done, you know, people will come and give us leads. Like, okay, so there's tax evasion at the port. This and this is happening, and you know, they usually give a lot more specific information that relates to their own issues. So a lot of people who come and speak to us usually have an axe to grind. But then our job is to go and verify the facts, figure out whether it's true, etc. Then there's also some that we feel we want to investigate. So, so like last year, we did a story on police brutality during the COVID curfew period.
Yeah,
and you know, just trying to find out what all of that was about, going back into the past. So there's a different mix. I mean, when you're looking at the kinds of stories you want to cover, but generally the rule is that it has to be in the public interest, not interesting to the public, right? So there's a subtle distinction there. Yeah. It can be interesting to the public, but as long as it's public interest. But, you know, to give an example of a story that might be interesting to the public, some public, what is the color of Rihanna's, you know, negligee or something like that, you know?
Well done.
Remember the disclaimer we gave when you came onto the show? We told you that we'd move from one side.
Mimejikaza kitako. Okay, no, sawa, no, let's go.
How did you manage to get into places like Somalia? Get the protection. It's not easy because many people have tried, many have failed, many are still trying and they have failed.
Okay, so Somalia is interesting. So of course the official route you'll go through Amisom, like now today. When we went to Somalia, we actually didn't go to Somalia, now Mogadishu, the first time, tulienda Somaliland, because that was the time that piracy was really, really like sky high. And man, hey, we had to negotiate with some of the guys who were part of the leadership there to give us protection. That was the most expensive trip that I've ever been on.
Yeah.
Ukona umebeba pesa za kampuni, lakini zinatoka, yani you're like, ay, okay, so even then we'll just eat rice and water for the rest of the trip. So it was a tough trip, but it was interesting. Then other times, you know, you just sneak across the border. It's a long, very long border between Kenya and Somalia. You sneak across, do what you need to do, come back, stuff like that. But
solo with protection.
Well, okay, the times you're sneaking across, you're going to end on a protection. You're going to end up to, you know,
solo mm-hmm. you know, but Somalia is not the place that people think it is. You know, like when people say Somalia, they're like, oh my God, it's so dangerous and stuff. Mm-hmm. Like when I went to Mogadishu the first time, I was astounded at how beautiful that city is.
Mm.
And you can see what it must have been like living there in the 70s,
Italian 80s. Architecture.
I'm telling you, man, like that place was the bomb, and the beach.
Oh.
Really fantastic.
It's the best beach in the world.
One of the best beaches in the world. Because, you know, it extends from Kiunga going up Ras Kamboni all the way.
It's the longest sea line. I mean, in the whole of Africa.
Yes.
They've got the longest.
The longest shoreline. Yeah, that's true. And the most deep ports. So, like, if Somalia was to be a peaceful country, it'd be one of the most powerful countries in Africa. That I can say for sure.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, are there any stories that you guys came up with and you thought you've done a good job and then they were just shut down?
Shut down, managed, yeah, there are a few. So there was a story that we did on the 2013 election.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, you remember that one, that was the first time there was a Supreme Court petition and all of that. And so we wanted to find out, like, what really happened in that election now with procurement of technology. You know, that was our first election using, you know, BVR kits, etc. But also the result. Let's just put it this way. We were told in no uncertain terms that you can go this far but no further.
Wow.
Sisi na vichwa ngumu, mimi na Moha and our producer Kasim and Sam, our cameraman, were like, apana, tutaskuma. So when we came back from gathering all the evidence, tumerusha promo on air. So guys have watched it for 5 minutes and it's gone down. So we ask, hey, what's happened? Kume has been pulled down by management. They're like, hey, you guys, nobody told you guys. Yeah. So that story got previewed so many times, and then you can tell when guys are being pedantic. Now I can say this now because I'm no longer working there. You know, guys are being pedantic. They're trying to massage your story, telling you you can only count this number of results from constituencies. When umehassle, umepata all of the forms 34 from across the country, then you're told you can only count 12 constituencies.
Wow.
You know, so we unaambiwa, yeah, just tone down. Then I mean, the final straw with that story was, the Sunday that we were running it, a rival newspaper had it on its front page. And worse than that, they lifted quotes directly from my script.
Oh, wow.
Like directly from my script.
Wow. Right? It was interesting. Right now, we're going to come back and we're going to talk about what you're doing right now.
All right.
But we're going to talk about Tusker Malt right now. Kenya Conservatory of Music and Tusker Malt present the International Women's Day concert weekend, and an epic performance by an all-female music orchestra at the Nairobi National Museum. That's on Friday the 4th and the 5th of March next week, from 7 p.m. Tickets are available on M Tickets. You can behold the finest. They'll be featuring Fina Gitu.
Oh, yeah.
There's Motra Music, Kike Dance,
Nanjala, Spellcast Troubles. I mean, it's actually going to be something worth attending. So more details are coming up. I think hearing what he's talking about, we need to, you will play for us Mike and the Mechanics looking over your shoulder.
Okay, David Sayaga standing by with business news. I mean, with sports right now, of course. It's not only 20 minutes, 5 o'clock. Capital FM.
It's Friday. Time to let DJ Leo does what he does best. Total satisfaction guaranteed. can only be one king, DJ Leo.
I can see Martin's eyes. This song takes you somewhere,
oh,
man.
Did friend, you? Let me tell you, this was what we call romance for young guys.
Oh,
it was brilliant stuff in a matatu.
Mm.
I wanna sex you up. That's a good song, but just telling you guys that we are celebrating women in the finest way possible. Tusker Malt, the Kenyan Conservatory of Music, and Tusker Malt Lager present the International Women's Day concert happening next Friday and Thursday at the Nairobi National Museum on the 4th, that's the 4th and the 5th of March from 7 p.m. Tickets are available on M-Tickets. Fena Gitu will be there on stage. And let's remember, when we go there, please do not drink excessively. Have fun responsibly. Yeah. Do not drink and drive. Tusker Malt, behold the finest. Now to John Allan Namu.
The finest, yes. The finest.
That is what you're saying.
The Mubaba in the studio, who is the finest. Somebody has called on online.
Okay. The ladies were watching news just because of him sometimes. Most times, actually. What are you up to nowadays, man?
So now I'm at Africa Uncensored. I co-founded Africa Uncensored about 6 years ago. Mm-hmm. So it's in-depth investigative journalism. Done well, done right. So we do lots of documentaries, lots of short stories. We've just recently co-published a story on this global financial leak called Swiss Leaks.
Yeah.
So that's the kind of stuff that we're doing now.
Plus, we also do lots of interesting content. Our most recent YouTube series is on money, but it's a story of money told by money. It's called Thao. It's a story in Sheng. It's a pretty interesting narrative. So it's not like hard maths, ninizo hesabu zako mato. Like it's easy to, it's friendly. Mm. And just generally trying to be to build the organization, try to make sure that we go as far as we can and to spread our wings.
Ken Gita was asked, how does one pitch for content to you?
Okay, so you write to us at info@africancensored.net. Depending on what your pitch is like, of course we'll evaluate it and whether it's interesting or it's just not for us. Then we look at the budget. You see, we see whether we can pay for the content that you have. If we can't, then we can give an option to publish for you. If that's not suitable, then but it's really as simple as that. As long as it meets our values, then it's something that we can do.
Remember, I'm the guy who throws you all around. So what would a John Allan Namu of today tell the John Allan Namu of 20 years ago?
Hey, Pogi, it wasn't me who asked that question this time.
So 20 years ago, I was 19. What would I tell? Well, that's a tough one.
Play more rugby, go out, so, you know.
Well, definitely play more rugby. And
would you change teams?
Never ever. Kwendo.
Okay.
It's good to ask.
Never ever. Even if things go bad for us this weekend, bado tuko on this damu.
That's the way it's done,
Yeah. We die with our teams. And just like spend a lot more time just learning about the world. I think the time now, when you're 19, you're more excited. You just gotten an ID. You want to get into every club, blah blah blah. But there's so much. It's such a big world. You know, I think I definitely have spent a lot more time just learning about my surroundings. And by my world, it's not just outside the country, just different regions. You know, sometimes like sitting here in Nairobi, we think that Nairobi is Kenya, and there are a lot of guys who never left Nairobi that think that they're at the center of the world. But honestly, journalism has made me have a new appreciation for this country. There are corners of this country that I've been to that, my friend, if I tell you what happens there, unaweza shanga.
So you and Solo.
Me and Solo.
Solo.
Oh, Bundubasha's. Yes.
Traveling to places.
No, but him, this is luxury travel, you know.
What do you mean luxury travel?
Let me tell you, the first time I went to Kiunga, we shared a mattress with our crew, a paper-thin mattress. Na tulikuwa tunakula chapati, like we shared chapos, me, Moha, and Dominic, our cameraman, for like 4 or 5 days.
Wow.
You're going into the bush, the buffaloes, setse flies. Also,
that's just boarding school for other guys.
Like Upper Hill.
Kumbe, I was traumatized by something you're going through every day.
You're talking about a guy in Garbatula is in class, a lion Peter's katikati. That's normal life in boarding.
Oh my God.
But yeah, so.
Hey, anyway, you're boarding sikupitia. So I just laugh at you guys. But yeah, I mean, like, there's corners of this country that I wish I'd started touring when I was that young. So if you're young, take the time to look, just go and find out what your country is about.
Nice.
Because as you get older, it's tougher.
Yeah,
responsibilities.
There are a lot more responsibilities.
Any more new stories that we could watch out for? Something interesting, something that is...
Yes. So we've got an election series that's coming up, a series of election documentaries that we're going to be doing over the next couple of months. We're going to be doing a couple of really in-depth investigations. I can't talk to you about what they are right now. But right before August, utakuwa na copy, and there's a bunch of them. And then in January next year, you know, because we are going to be spending most of this year producing, there's going to be a very interesting series. Again, contracts and stuff, I can't talk too much, but keep your eyes peeled. It'll be on local TV.
Okay.
Let's see, what else? We're starting podcasting at Africa Uncensored. I'm also going to be doing my own thing on that. And just generally being a good Kenyan.
Yeah, fantastic. Yes, hobbies? Yes. Any hobbies you have? Apart from going to Saints, that's a hobby.
no. There is no. Going to Saints was a privilege. Let's start there. It was a privilege. Hobbies, gosh, you know, because my life is so, like, there's so much happening at work.
Yeah.
I really just like to kick back and do very little. So it's Netflix. Now these days it's watching stuff with the kids, going out with them.
Mm-hmm.
If there's one hobby that I really, really wish I could get into, it's... oh my gosh, my wife is going to laugh at me. But I really want
don't
to learn.
Tell
how
me
to
pottery.
No.
I know this is bird watching.
No. That one is for Akina Wallace Kantai.
Yeah. cameras.
Yeah. And me Wallace, and that, I don't
and
understand.
And binoculars.
The guy works in a bank the whole week. Yeah. Then you want to go and just sit and look for birds.
But nice.
Huh? Yeah. Okay, the pictures are nice.
Yeah, by the way. No,
much
that's
respect
why I
to you, Wallace.
Mm-hmm.
But hey man, that's a tough hobby. Okay, so hobbies, I really wanted to learn how to do, like, you know, some of these dances that these guys do in the Caribbean. Not
salsa and
not
flamenco
salsa,
and
not, there's another one
samba
that they do in like the Dominican Republic, I forgot.
Okay, okay.
There was a time we were on a trip in Amsterdam and we passed by this bar. And that's all they were doing. That's the first time I ever got offered the
Yes.
Okay. But
okay.
Of course, I did not.
Ladies and gentlemen, John Allan Namu, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you guys for having me. I appreciate it.
Social media avenues for those who'd like to reach you.
Ah, great. So at John Allan Namu on Twitter, John Allan Namu on Facebook, although I'm not there much. For Africa Uncensored, it's at AF Uncensored on Twitter, at AF Uncensored on Instagram. Africa Uncensored is the YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
We've got new stuff coming out this week, so go and check it out.
Asante right, sana.
Thank you.
Good all stuff, right, man. Funny. That was awesome. A Saints girl who speaks well.
But that's everybody.
No.
Hey, who don't you know that, Nini?
Dudus was here, but not, yeah.
Dudus was not in Saints. Dudus was in Tagoret. Dudus went to Saints.
Yes.
To do what? Okay, Dago was the first point.
Dudus. No.
He was in Dago.
Dudus. He learned Kiswahili in Dago and then went to Saints to learn English.
I couldn't sleep, cause I had it up. us up on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
This is the best song on earth. PM Dawn, Precious Eyes. It's brilliant. Looking through at your precious eyes. Looking through patient eyes at your precious eyes. It's released in 1993.
It was a beautiful song.
1993 was what? 29 years ago. 29 years ago.
I remember when... Now, please, don't start judging us first. Eh? I'm just trying to give you the story. So when KTN started, CNN was introduced to Kenyans.
Yeah.
And they brought up a story of how this... he was big-built. He was picked on in high school. And it kind of drove his inspiration to sing.
Who?
See, that is...
The PM Dawn guy.
Yes.
The one of them.
Yes.
The big one.
The big one.
Oh, he was picked on.
He was picked on. He was bullied because of his size.
Yeah.
He was tall and big. But... it continued to make him better, and I mean, if you look all around him, those Heavy D,
yeah,
those B.I.G.,
yeah,
who had actually made it in the world with their size, despite their size.
Now, speaking of KTN and all that, yesterday at Deja Vu, we were sitting with our friends. Of also, congratulations, Alvin Tracheri. Looks so awesome on the in the Business Daily with your big chest out. I was sitting down with Patricia Washira, Emiano Mushiri, and a couple of other people as well. And Charles Kiariak was also there.
So, I've seen him dancing.
A song Chomokad, and Danki was also there as well. A song was being played by the DJ. It was actually Tina Turner, What's Love Got to Do with It?
Yes.
So, Patty asked, who asked us what year was it? Amiano asked us, what year was this song released? We told him 1984. Then he asked, were there color TVs then?
Oh, good question. I remember that hilarious moment.
Were there color TVs then?
1984.
As in, you know, color TV was first in, first Chomokad came to Kenya in 1978.
Okay.
Color TV was
what
not
if we used to. Okay, there was no TV then, so yeah.
There was no color TV. When you watch World Cup 86, all the teams were either black or white.
Yeah.
There was no color TV. So, Amma, you had that gold star. Was it the gold star? The one that you put a piece of paper with the three primary colors.
Yes, that's what we used.
That's
actually.
All.
Yeah.
Now, come 1990, we have KTN 62. We have, you know, all multi parties coming.
Yes.
Yeah, and all that stuff. Everyone has a color TV. We realize that, you know, Bayern Munich play in red, not black.
Yeah. And white.
White.
Gray and white.
Then, fast forward, we have tapes now. Yes. Fast forward, a few years later, we're on CDs.
Yeah.
The question came up again. Which CD did you own first? Album?
Mine was, what's the name? Snoop Dogg, Doggy Style.
Mine was Bone Thugs and Harmony, the first EP.
Wow.
The first EP.
Was, can't remember.
For the Love of the Money and all that stuff was in there.
Yes, yes.
Charles?
Steel tape.
Steel tape.
Yeah.
No.
TD90.
New edition or somewhere. I'm just saying. I'm seeing new edition, but I remember Bobby Brown. His first song, the one that just went boom.
Yeah.
It was a single.
Yeah. When he went single. Yes. Yeah. When he left a new edition.
That's the question you're asking. The first CD you owned.
Which whether, one was whether, it? Whether you bought or you given or you took. Yes.
So, or you borrowed.
Yeah. Don't be cruel.
Don't be cruel.
Yeah, Bobby Brown, don't be cruel.
At the Jam 94, the hashtag is The Boy's Life. The first CD you owned when CDs came to, as in a pre 1990 born.
When you moved, when people were moving away from tapes, the TD60, the TD90, and moved into music that was clearer, that had, in quotes, the Dolby Surround had just come out.
Yeah.
So you had home theaters moving away from the
boombox.
Boombox.
Yeah.
Wow.
When you stopped carrying around the radio, now it could no longer, if you shake it, it'll stop playing. It'll skip. Forget about these CD players that we have in the cars now.
Yeah.
They'll play a CD and it'll not skip. This one, if you shook that radio, the CD stops playing.
Don't be cruel.
Yeah.
Record.
We're jamming with the boys and karaoke.
A good, good white cap is always nice. A cold one.
Yeah.
I'm celebrating the mountain called Mount Kenya, of course, and our, you know, culture. White cap, the beer of true distinction. Remember, no drink and drive. Drink responsibly. You know, enjoy responsibly as well. Alcohol is not for sale to people or persons under the age of 18 years. White cap, the beer of true distinction. Somebody has called you a young man.
Me?
Yeah, prof.
Hey.
He has said, you see, you asked that question of the 20 years ago question, which so happens that you have asked it so many times.
Mm-hmm.
In over 50 episodes of
the jam.
Of our rugby stories.
Mm. Oh, is that?
I've asked it 51 times. As I got into Pogi.
Yeah.
But however, so that this Jabrov does not think you're a young man. Solo. Before, listen, there are things that kids of the 80s did. And or the 70s, born 70s, born 80s, before the 90s, that are not available anymore now.
Playing outside.
Your kids don't play outside?
Nowadays, no. At what games? Where are they playing? First, it's a concrete jungle. We played Bano on soil.
You played
We played Bano on soil. Now they're playing it on pavements and paved roads.
They're playing. How do they play Bano on paved roads?
Potholes.
Potholes. Also, here's another thing that's not there anymore.
Mm-hmm.
It's gone. Remember your landlines? Do you remember your landline number?
Guy.
You know, every estate had its own area code and number.
Yeah.
I can't remember the landline number, but I remember we used to have two extensions. So I used to tell, there was a way we used to like tap the phone and make a call, or you leave, you know, the phone used to be fungo with the padlock.
Yes.
So you don't call. So we learned how to open the key. So you're talking to your girlfriend at night, then you hear your dad, aya yumetosha. Mkalale sasa.
Aya. It was a landline.
Yeah.
Then fast forward to the future. Kina Raj said, Raj actually told us yesterday, a friend of ours called Alvin Rachel told us that they had one phone in their estate. It was them. Yeah. In their block of whatever. Mm-hmm. It was their phone. So when the phone call comes in, you pick it up, then they say, I want to talk to karaoke house B4. Rachi sent to B4
call the
to
neighbor.
Call the neighbor. You have a phone call.
Do you know you had, there was a book for writing messages for missed calls?
Yes.
Mm. So you don't forget, because some of us used to be told, tell him I called. And then, who called me? Hmm? No, who called me? Was there any call for me? Hmm? Yeah, so
let me ask something. Did you?